Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with the data communication subject. So far we have discussed about the different layers, how the data communication will be established by using different layers in the different stages, that is the data link layer, physical layer, transport layer, network layer. Now let's see the application layer, how the data communication will be established in the application layer. Application layer is the most important, as this is the, because as this is the only layer present at the top of the OSI model. Application layer is the most important. Why we call it as the most important? Because it is the only layer present at the top of the OSI model and through which users can interact it. Main thing is the user is going to interact with the system with the help of the application layer. Because it is the topmost of the OSI model, so whatever the system you are taking, the client and the server, if you want to make a communications between the client and the server, the first it has to interact with the application layer, and here also the server has to interact with the application layer. Okay, here the client and servers are nothing but the users. Let's take this are the users. Application layer is the most important, as this is the only one layer, only layer present at the top of the OSI model and through which user can interact it. It provides service to the user. The main thing of application layer, it is providing service to the user. Let's take one of the example for the application layer, that is a client server model. The client server model is one of the application for the application layer. In client server model, any process can access a server or a client, okay, either this side or that side. So I'm one time I'm act as a server, next time I may act as a client. Suppose I'm interacting with you students, I'm the server and you are the clients. Okay, suppose if I'm interacting to my teacher and I'm the client and my teacher was a server, like that. So if in client server model, any process, any person can access a server or a client. It is not the type of the machine and the size of the machine or its computing power which make it server. Okay, this point you have to be remembered, that it is not the type of the machine, whatever the client system you are taking, whatever the server system you are taking, it is, we are not talking about the type of the machine and the size of the machine or its computing power which makes it server. It is the ability of the serving request that makes a machine a server. So that's the thing. It is the, we are talking about the ability of the serving request, which system is having the ability of the serving request that makes as a machine a server, not the type of the machine and the size of the machine. Okay, so see here the client server model. Here let's take a system, any server, or it sometimes it's a server acts as a server and it acts as a client. Here the systems are there, all connected in the network. Here it is requesting and the server is giving the response. A system can act as a client and server simultaneously. How can a system can act as a client and server simultaneously? That is, one system can act as a server and other system as a client. This time, next time the other system can act as a client and next system acts as a server. They are acting client-server simultaneously. It also happens that both client and server process resides on a same machine. There may be a chance in the single machine both the client and servers may be present. Okay, it may happen. Let's see the communication. So whatever the communication that is going to be established in the application layer, there is two process in client server model that interact with various ways. One is a socket and another remote processor call. With the help of these two process, a communication will be established in the client server model. So what is a socket interface? Now let's see the sockets. You all know socket, a general, it's a wire cable. A socket is going to be connected to the point, one of the plug point. A socket is connecting to your system. A socket is connecting to your mobile phone. Okay. So why we are connecting with the socket? Because a socket is going, it's a one end of the process which is used for the communication. The process acting as a server opens a socket using a well-known port and waits until some client request comes. And the second process acting as a client also, client also opens a socket, but instead of waiting for incoming request, the client process request first. It's just a two-way communication. Once the server program and the client program both are connected with one side one socket, another side another socket. Obviously, if the wire has to be connected to two systems, one end one socket should be there, another end another socket should be there. With the help of the socket, a communication is going to be established. Suppose one acts as a socket here, whatever the server opens a socket using a well-known port and waits until some client request is coming. So until it will wait until the client request is coming. The second process, acting as a client, also opens a socket, but instead of waiting for the incoming request, it's just responding to the request first. So the client is first asking the server. Okay, so I am asking my teacher. The student is asking the teacher what we have to do. So it's a client process. The client is process request first, then the server is responding. So when request is reached to the server, it is served. It can either be information sharing or resource request. So whatever the message it is getting, it can be either an information sharing or resource request. So this is about the application layer, that is a client server model. Thank you.